Service safe. Remember, remember, the 5th of November, the Gunpowder Treason and Plot. Hello, Buzzkillers. It's your old friend the Professor here. That was the beginning of the famous children's rhyme about Guy Fawkes, one of the most iconic people in British history. Nowadays, thanks to the movie V for Vendetta, remember that one? He's become a symbol of resistance to oppressive authority everywhere. Guy Fawkes masks are worn at protests by the Occupy movement and by other anti-establishment protest groups in Britain, in the USA, in Poland, India, Bahrain, Thailand, Turkey, Brazil, and Venezuela. Yes, Buzzkillers, I looked it up. The Canadian and Saudi Arabian governments have even banned the masks. Now listen, your old friend the Professor certainly sympathizes with all you Buzzkillers protesting against oppression of any kind. And, of course, you have the fundamental right to wear whatever you want, masks or not. But it's also my sacred historical duty to point out that no matter how cool the Guy Fawkes masks look, and they do look cool, they represent the sentiments of the V for Vendetta movie far more than the real political ideologies of Guy Fawkes and his fellow anti-government conspirators in London back in 1605. This is what happened, killers. Guy Fawkes was a member of the Gunpowder Plot, which was a conspiracy to assassinate King James I and kill a great many government leaders. They planned to blow up the House of Lords during the state opening of Parliament on the 5th of November, 1605. That's why it's always remembered on the 5th of November. The king and all the major parliamentarians would be there and all the government would be there. The plotters would then reestablish a Catholic monarch, a Catholic government, and a Catholic Church of England. But because of a letter that got leaked, the plot was found out, and King James ordered the parliamentary building searched for explosives. In the undercroft of the House of Lords, that's right, I said undercroft, guards found many casks of gunpowder that were actually being guarded by Guy Fawkes, who wasn't, by the way, wearing a mask. They arrested him, they tortured him, until he gave up the names of the other conspirators and they were all executed. What makes the Guy Fawkes story, or perhaps more accurately, the image of Guy Fawkes displayed by the masks, you know, a poor icon for modern-day resistance to oppressive authority, is that Guy and his fellow conspirators wanted to replace one top-heavy government of elites, that was the Protestant establishment of King James I, with another top-heavy government of elites, a Catholic establishment headed by Elizabeth Stuart, who was the daughter of James I. Now that gets complicated, but trust me, killers, one top-heavy establishment of elites with another top-heavy establishment of elites. The plan was to put the young Elizabeth Stuart on the throne, raise her as a Catholic, marry her off to another Catholic monarch or prince from another European country, and reestablish that establishment, if you will. None of the gunpowder plotters were trying to upend English society or create a workers' or paupers' paradise. For the vast majority of people in England and Scotland, the only change would be the official religion of the state. Ordinary people would go about their everyday lives being poor and having little prospect of improving those lives. Now, Buzzkillers, there's a lot more to the question of what quashing the gunpowder plot meant for the development of English and Scottish liberty, but this is a mini-myth, and we can't go on for too long because you've got stuff to do. So, but listen, go ahead, Buzzkillers. Fight the power. But choose the mask of a real radical and a political rebel. It'll make us historians happy. And I know how important that is to you. Talk to you next week. Adios.